seriously. Here we go, Aria Li. You ready to do some drawing and painting together?
Yes.
All right. This is sketchygoichie, kids draw too. Now, what do you want me to draw?
So I only want to draw poison ivy.
Poison ivy?
Yeah. I have rainbow colors, but I'm gonna make something up with these rainbow colors.
Okay. So I'm gonna start with a crayon. I think I'm gonna start because it's poison ivy. I'm gonna start with how about a green crayon?
Yeah.
Yeah? So let me find a nice dark green crayon to use to draw poison ivy for you. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Since poison ivy has orange hair and green costume? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'll draw her this way, the tall way. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, poison ivy for Aria Li. So first thing, we'll start with her face. I'm gonna do like how Daddy always draws them, like a nice
Daddy,
little short one.
What? I think we could draw her whole body.
Whole body? Okay. So we'll draw her, but we'll draw her if she's like tiny. We'll make her like a tiny one. Okay? So you know Daddy always starts with the little drawings.
That looks like a big one.
You'll see. It's gonna look, hopefully it'll look good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it looks like she's fat.
She looks like chunky?
Yeah.
All right, that's okay. Like chunky is good.
It looks like when me and Sissy destroyed Mama's belly.
What? Saying she looks pregnant?
She always looks like that, and I don't want to hurt her feelings by saying fat.
Yeah, that would hurt people's feelings. That's not a nice word, right? So that we pick something more polite to say.
Yeah.
For people.
I said, what happened to your belly?
Yeah, who did you say that to?
Mama.
You did? Wait a minute, how can you be in her belly and still ask her questions?
Because I don't remember what I was like when I was a baby.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You have that memory? Yeah. That's pretty amazing that you have memory of stuff when you was a baby. That's pretty amazing.
Yeah.
That is very amazing. All right? Mm-hmm. So, we're going to draw. So, see? I'm going to draw her costume.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You mean dress?
Does she wear a dress?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
And that way, I'm gonna draw, look at, she's got little short hands.
Yeah.
Right? And a little body.
And to be real high, poison ivy has poison ivy trees on her.
She does?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Like it goes around her and on her.
Okay, so you mean vines? She has like vines there?
Yeah.
All right, I'll draw some vines on her too.
They're green vines.
Green vines? Well, it's good that I'm starting in green, huh?
Mm-hmm. Why is she jumping?
Trust me, she's not gonna be jumping when we're done. You're gonna like it, I think. I hope you will.
Yeah, I know.
I hope you like it. All right, so that's that part of it.
Oh, she doesn't, I thought that was her dress.
Does she have boots? I think she does, right?
No, she has shoes.
Little shoes?
Green shoes.
Okay, so I'm gonna draw some green shoes and her upper body here, her little dress is green too.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
And super high, her greens are, at least she's all green, her eyes are green.
Her eyes are green too. And then I'm gonna draw some, so you want me to draw vines?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll draw some vines. This is gonna be for you, this is gonna be your part.
Maybe you could draw some green gloves and some vines on her arms.
All right, so I'll draw some green gloves. Okay, some green gloves.
Is that a vine tail?
Yeah, I'm gonna do a vine tail like that, and I'll make it swirly and curly. Swirly and curly.
Do you know who's my favorite superhero?
Who?
Harley Quinn.
Is Harley Quinn a superhero?
Yes, I'm superhero. Sure? Hi.
Oh, and superhero high she is, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
But in the real superheroes.
In the real superhero story, is she?
No, she's not in there.
She's not?
In this real superhero movie, she's not.
Oh, okay. Which movie is that?
Where they're all kids, superhero kids, no villains.
I don't know if I've ever seen that one.
Does her?
Is it on, what channel does it come on? Do you remember?
It's... So it used to be on YouTube, but now it's on, it used to be on YouTube, but now it's on What's that kid one that has lots of sections?
The new one that you've been starting watching? Yeah. Are you talking about HBO Max? That one?
Yeah. It's on that one now.
Pretty interesting how you know all the channels, baby.
Yeah.
Isn't that interesting? All right, so what I'm going to do is, so there's her vines.
Can we go above her hair?
I'm going to do a little one over here, too.
I was thinking I could paint her hair purple.
I think orange would look nice.
No, purple.
This is your, listen, you're the color person, so I'm just going to handle that part. But I'm going to draw it in orange, though. And you can color it whatever you want, all right?
I'm going to color it.
All right? Because I'm pretty sure her character, she's got orange hair.
Yeah, I know, I just want to draw purple hair.
Well, you can draw it any way you want. This is, we're having fun, right?
No.
Draw anything you want. So I'm going to draw her.
Because I'm the drawer and he is the, he is the drawer to the person.
What, the artist?
Yeah. He's,
I think we're both the artists on this one.
Yeah.
Right, wouldn't you say?
But I'm bad at drawing people.
No, you're not.
Like,
you draw people really well.
I was trying to make a thank you picture for the movie.
Okay.
And I accidentally drew Mrs. Stratton.
You're a preschool teacher. You drew her like that?
Yeah.
All right. So you ready to start painting?
Yes.
Okay, so that's that part of it. Now it's time for Aria Li time. What color are you going to start with?
Purple.
So, grab your purple color. Put some water. Now this comes out nice and thick, so just remember that.
Yeah.
Ooh, look at that. I like how you put a little bit of water in it too, to wash it down. Mm-hmm. See? Oh, I see what you're doing. So you're gonna make her whole, everything that's orange, you're gonna make it purple?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I think you don't even necessarily need the water unless you want to water it down.
No, I was trying to like just the paint. Water.
Okay. Oh. You're doing little curly parts of her hair?
I'm doing those parts.
Okay, so everything that's orange, you're gonna make it, turn it, you're gonna turn it to purple?
No, I'm gonna use the parts where white.
Okay.
As purple.
Okay. Oh, I see. So you're gonna use the highlights, the highlighted parts. Those are gonna be the purple part.
Uh huh.
Oh, I get it. Okay. A little curl there of her hair.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nice.
They got that.
I see. Well, you got a lot of paint on that brush, huh?
Yeah. I was like that.
Okay.
But then I'm not gonna put too much on my brush.
Okay. Sure. Yeah, we'll put a little towel over here. Whenever you're done with the brushes and you want to start a new brush, you can put it on there. Okay.
I'm gonna
wash that off. Okay, just leave it there if you want.
No.
Okay. What's the next color you're gonna do? You're gonna put some green on?
The next color is gonna be blue.
Okay, what's gonna be blue?
Her dress.
Okay. Oh, you're really being experimenting, huh, with colors?
Too much against me.
It's okay. We're just painting. We're having fun.
Yeah, I know.
Ah. Can do that part of her dress?
So that part as her dress is going to be part of her dress.
Okay. So that whole, like the upper part of her dress is going to be blue like that?
And, yeah.
Do you want to swirl the, you want to fill the blue in? Like fill the areas in?
A lot of blue is
not that much paint. You got a lot of paint in the brush, so you're pretty good. You're in good shape. Okay. Oh, you're doing like the little leaf part of her dress that goes along the back side of her?
No, I'm gonna so the dress parts, the end parts of her dress is gonna be blue.
Oh, I see.
And her dress color is gonna be red.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure.
I thought you were gonna make her lips red.
No.
What color are you gonna make her lips?
Purple.
Purple again?
Yeah.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Alright, you're the color person. How about her gloves and her boots?
Okay.
You gonna make those blue too?
No, I'm gonna make those yellow and green.
Okay. So what's next?
So next is
you can put it right there next to the purple brush for now. case you need it later.
I'm gonna use red now.
Okay, what's gonna be the red?
This.
Wow, that's a nice big brush. You can do a lot of
areas with that. I was making sure it was fit. But a brush can fit inside.
Okay, so what's gonna be red?
Her dress, remember?
Okay, let's see. Oh, the inside part of it, I see. Oh, now I get it. And what else did you say that you read? Her boots and her gloves? Did you say that?
No. Her boots and her, well, her boots are going to be orange and yellow.
Okay.
And her gloves are going to be purple and blue.
All right, so what else is going to be red? She must, while you have the brush, you might as well use all the reds. All the stuff that's going to be red, you might as well do it now. Right? Oh, see, it's starting to mix together, huh? Because the blue is still a little bit wet.
Yeah. So the end of the colors are right here.
Mm-hmm. See, now when you put it in the water, it makes it really watery. Right? It's a good thing we're working on this watercolor paper, huh? Okay. Yeah, you don't have to worry about that. You can just put it down. The brush will be fine.
Okay, next. I'm going to use purple again,
so
I'm going to use purple on a little bit of purple on her end of her dress parts.
Okay, good. So you're glad you saved the purple brush? That brush is only for purple, huh?
Mm-hmm. Good. I like using brushes in the same color as they are.
Yeah, that way you know which brush you can use, huh?
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty smart. Where'd you get that idea from?
Myself.
Oh, you did, huh?
I got that idea from the brushes.
Oh, you did, okay.
Yeah, because they're all color. Mm-hmm. And when we first got these ones, I was thinking at least they look pretty. We could use the colors. We could use the colors and the exact colors as the paintbrushes.
Okay, so what's the next color?
Well, it's still purple because I'm not done.
Oh, I thought you were done. Okay. Excuse me, I can't interrupt your artistic process. Oh, I see.
I'm mixing it.
Swirly pattern there you're making, huh?
I'm mixing it.
You know what's the funny thing, baby?
What?
You put the red down, you put the blue down. Did you know if you put the red and the blue together, they make purple? Uh-uh, don't put it in the blue.
I'm putting both colors so they can.
Yeah, but now you're gonna put blue into the purple. See? You put a dab of blue, now it's in there. Oh, so I was saying, yeah, if you put those two colors together, they make purple.
No, red and blue makes purple.
Yep, okay. What's next?
Well, I'm gonna wash it now.
Okay, so you put your brush over here with these guys.
Oh, look at that. It made dark blue.
Yeah, see? I see. It did. Because it's got purple and blue mixed together. Mm-hmm. All right, don't ruin the brush. You don't want to squeeze it down too much. I'm really curious to see what these boots are gonna look like in yellow.
You mean yellow and green?
Mm-hmm. All right.
Now I'm done with her dress.
Okay. You need to put your brush right here. Okay, next.
Okay, next I'm gonna do is her face.
Okay, what color?
So I'm gonna grab a yellow for her face and for her eye, I'm gonna do.
You want me to see if I can find big brush for the yellow?
I already got one, see?
Okay.
But I'm gonna use black. Remember I said I like to use...
Maybe, what if you did all her skin in yellow?
No.
You'll do it your own way,
actually, yeah.
Okay. Nice.
Is there lines on her arm? Because I can't see it. Oh, I forgot about the
kernels
right there.
Okay. Is there what?
I forgot the kernels right there.
Oh, it's okay.
That's where you're drying my hair.
There you go. That's where... You're funny. Oh, I see. You're painting all the skin is yellow now. I see. There you go. Now you got some nice brush.
Because her skin is yellow.
Mm-hmm.
And Cheetah Girl, her skin is brown.
Okay. Let's see hers in yellow. Can I paint some too with you?
Yeah.
All right. Let me grab.
You can use the big brushes. Oh, careful.
I'm going to use a big brush. Do my part.
That one's a big brush over here.
Even though this is green, but I'm gonna use it.
I think I got paint on your brush.
Yeah, you got a little bit of paint. Alright. I'll work with you a little bit. Okay, we'll do it together. I'm gonna do the neck.
Okay.
Arms. And I'm gonna do the legs, okay? There we go. One thing I like about drawing it with crayon, notice how that when we put the color, this watercolor on top, it doesn't take away the crayon. Mm-hmm. It stays there. It doesn't even bother it, right?
Next, I'm gonna do her eyes.
Okay, what color are you gonna make her eyes?
I'm gonna do it in green.
Green time, huh? Mm-hmm. Okay, time for green.
Put a little bit of green in there.
Well, that's a lot of green.
No, it's a little bit.
Alright, we'll see. Okay, put it down before it drips.
Oh, I forgot about which part I'm gonna do green.
There you go. Okay. Now what?
Okay.
What are the parts? I thought you were gonna do the sleeves in green too.
No, I'm gonna do the sleeves purple and blue. You're getting colors mixed up now.
I am. I could have swore I asked you to do the purple and the blue, and you said you were doing it in green.
No.
Maybe I'm mistaken.
The green.
Yeah, let me take this for you.
The green and yellow is for her boots.
Okay.
And the blue and purple is for her arms.
Oh, it just so happens I have a purple brush ready for you. It's nice if that's a bigger one so you can you put more color down.
No, that's a small one, see?
Okay.
That's a small hand.
Alright, let's see.
The another thing I like to do is put the water. I like to put the brushes and water and rainbow color. So purple goes in the end color.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Blue goes in the second color, and green goes in the end color, and the other colors go in the same way as the bottom does.
All right, well, let's see how you put it down. Let's see how you put it down on the paper.
Okay, so.
Okay, right over here.
Actually, I'm gonna use this brush. I'm gonna start with boots.
You're going back to yellow again?
No, her boots are yellow and green, remember? I don't know how many times I'll say, do you remember? For real.
How funny. Oh, you're a tough student.
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you. You're really the only one painting.
Why are you calling me a student then?
Because you're a student now. We're collaborators. We are partners.
No, you can call me graduated kid.
Graduated kid? Okay, I'll call you that.
Because I just graduated.
All right, baby, let's put some finishing touches
on this. I forgot to tell you I just graduated.
All right, so let's put the finishing touches on this painting. Because this one's not going to be an all-day painting. It's going to be just a quick painting. Put your final touches on here. All right, so that's one boot. It's green. All right, you want to do the sleeves before so we can finish it?
You mean gloves?
The gloves. Mm-hmm. So you're going purple with the gloves?
Yeah.
As you said many times.
Purple and blue.
Alright.
Keep on forgetting.
I have to keep forgetting, you're right.
Looks like she's still jumping.
Yeah, doesn't look like she's sitting on a big vine.
It looks like she's doing both.
If you say so. I'll tell you what, you paint, you do that, and I'll do the blue. Can I do the other sleeve in blue?
Yeah. That's what I said in my orders.
Okay, I'm going to do the other sleeve in blue. Okay.
You're funny too. Mm-hmm. Okay. What else I'm gonna do is paint the vines. So the vines are gonna be red.
Okay.
So it looks like she's gonna be evil.
Evil vines, huh?
Yeah. Oh.
Okay. All right. Evil vines coming up. Ooh, that's a perfect brush for evil vines, isn't it?
Yeah. Is that a vine?
Chunk. This is a big chunk. That's just a curly. Look at curls like that. That's just one. That's like one arm coming off of that. It's a big chunk in the middle.
Yeah. This brush is good for that vine.
Okay. All right. That's what it's good for?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It looks like it's a vine, it's so curly. I'm going to... Wait, how about I put this
hair? Alright, we're ready to finish it off. Mm-hmm. Okay, this last little bit and then we're going to be all done. Well, I like how light it is right now. Now we know when we use these paints, we can probably put a little dab of paint down and then a little bit of water on the side, and then we'll just grab the paint that way instead of reaching, going right out of the jar.
But I like using the jars.
I know. All right. I think we're just about done here, baby.
Yeah, I'm
forgetting those parts. All right, well, I'm just about done. So let's finish it up. You want to put your sign your name?
Yeah.
Okay, let me find a nice crayon to sign your name. Let's see, where can you put it? Here, can you put it really teeny tiny right there? Yeah, let me take that brush and put it with the other ones.
Well, I'm going to use paint instead for my name.
Oh, really?
I'm going to use an orange because I haven't used
orange.
Can
you make your name as tiny as possible right there? Tiny, tiny little A. Tiny. Okay.
When I use marker and A in small R, you can't see my A.
It's all right.
Tiny.
I don't know if it'll be able to fit there, baby, but just put A, Aria Andrew. I don't think you're going to be able to get the R, I, A in there.
Let's do A, R, and I.
Okay, for R, E. There you go. That's good?
Mm-hmm.
This is an Aria and Daddy piece.
Video.
As you can see, the fine color work of Aria Li Andrews.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you want to tell everybody thanks for watching?
Thanks for watching. It's real our faces.
You want to see our faces? Okay, put your face in there.
Let them see your face.
All right, goodbye.
Bye.
There you have it, Kids Draw 2. If you like what you see, click the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. Sketchygoichie, live your moment. Happy sketching, y'all.
Peace.